So good. I do love WaWa coffee. Actually, now that I think about it, some of the people watching this vlog probably have no clue what WaWa is. They are really huge on the East Coast, and they are probably the best place ever. It's basically a gas station and a convenience store type place, but if you haven't ever been to one, just go when you see one. Anyway, it's Wednesday and it's time for another great day. Excited for today. Lots on the agenda today. I have two meetings with two more potential brides, which is super exciting. And then I'm doing all I can to actually completely finish the project that I was talking about that I wanted to do yesterday, which was the new wedding film that I'm working on from a couple weeks ago. I'm trying to knock the entire thing out today. So really hoping I can do that. So as I'm preparing for this meeting with this couple, a lot of people ask me, you know, do I prefer to meet in person with them or over the phone, or what's the best technique, and do I think it's important to always meet in person? And the honest truth is, it really just depends on your company and your philosophy, but mine's kind of simple. Obviously, I love building relationships with people, and I do feel like I have extremely good sales skills when I talk to people, but at the same time, I also understand that people have budgets, and there are certain times that I know someone's very, very close in the budget of where they need to be, and I can definitely talk them into booking us and going a little bit more than their budget, but there are other times that if I clearly get an indication from somebody in an initial email or initial conversation that we are way out of their budget, then it just kind of, to me, seems silly really, really going after that lead hard. I get a lot of inquiries for weddings, obviously, on a regular basis, and I really have to weed out which ones I think are just straight up price shopping, or which ones honestly see us as a huge value and something that they want a part of their wedding day, and make the right decisions on that, because time is ultimately money. If I decided to meet with every single couple that contacts us in person and decided to buy them a coffee or buy them lunch or whatever it is, yes, it would be a nice thing to do, but at the same time, I'd be spending a lot of time. And I'm not really concerned about the money of buying someone a coffee or buying someone lunch, but it is time. And if I'm spending a couple of hours every single day meeting with different couples rather than spending a quick conversation on the phone or just a quick email back and forth, it's really important that I make sure that I'm spending my time wisely, because if I'm always just out meeting with people, I can never actually get any work done. But if I get an indication from someone in an email that clearly looks as though they're trying to either get me to match pricing of another company, or they're trying to get me to go cheaper than even the base price, I honestly don't see it as a big reason that I really, really should go after trying to pursue them for more than what they're looking to spend. Now, I will always respond to them very nicely and help them understand what our budgets are and where our pricing goes, but it is a templated email that I send to them that has some of that information, because it's important for me to just make sure that the people I'm talking to really, really value the work that we're doing at the cost that we're doing it. I've never been a person that negotiates pricing with people, and I just have our pricing set at what I feel like is the fair market for what I'm doing and the work that's going into it. I know that we're more expensive than some companies, maybe most companies, I don't really know. I don't pay much attention to my competitors at all. But I also feel like I know what we deliver, I know the relationships we build, and I know the stuff that we do for our couples, and they really ultimately have to decide if that's important to them. Out of all the leads that come to my email that I actually am available for, I have a success rate of probably 15 to 20-ish% of landing the job with them, and that's ultimately where I want to be. I forget who exactly said it, but I remember someone once telling me that if you're landing 30% or 40% of all your jobs, your prices are way too low, because you shouldn't really honestly be landing that many. Regardless how good you are at sales, if you're landing 30 to 40, 50% of every lead that comes your way, it means that you're probably good enough that you could just raise your prices. And ultimately what you have to realize is that if you do 10 projects at $1,000 a piece, or 5 projects at $2,000 a piece, it's the same amount of money. And I personally would rather put a lot of time and effort into the films and make more money on them and do less weddings than ultimately just put my pricing lower so I can book even more. I don't ultimately think I want to be doing 60, 70, 80 weddings a year. I try to cap out at about 25 weddings per year, 30 tops, and I try to make them worth the money that I'm going to spend a lot of time on. So that's kind of my philosophy, but everybody's different on that, and there's no right or wrong way for you to do it. It's just important for you to decide. Okay, time for a meeting. Hi, is this Lauren? Hi, Lauren, this is Scott with 4LC Studios. How are you? That went great. Sounds like a promising lead. Just an awesome couple that actually came across us from the teaser that we just did a couple weeks ago for one of the other weddings, which is great. It's amazing, like the leads that come from Facebook and Instagram and all these different things. It's incredible. You don't have to advertise like you used to. People do your advertising for you if you do a good job. That's my tip. So I'm on to editing this next wedding film. Every wedding's a little different in the manner of what I edit first and the process in which I do it. If I'm doing just the trailer versus if I'm doing full ceremony, full speeches and all that kind of stuff, it really depends on that. So I'm doing, in this case, they have a 3 to 5 minute trailer, but they also have a full ceremony, full speeches, and full first dances. So I will always edit those entirely first, because what it allows me to do is actually hear all the important things in the ceremony and the speeches and all that to be able to get a feel for what I can use in the actual trailer. So that's what I'm doing first, just a little multicam editing specifically for the speeches, the ceremony, and the dances. Let's get to work. Wrapped up the majority of my day, didn't quite finish the edit, but it's coming along really nicely, and literally in the last just 5 minutes, I just got a crazy urge to just change my desk around again, even though I just did it even cleaner. I'm obsessed with things being neat. It's time for some grilling. It is time. This could be the last walk before the baby. We'll see what happens. I mean, I doubt it, because he doesn't seem like he's in a rush to get here. While we're taking a walk, it's time for a quick family Q&A. Questions by me. What do you remember most about the day before giving birth to that girl?
I didn't sleep at all.
From nerves or from just not comfortable?
Well, no. No, I was very comfortable with her. I didn't sleep because I was nervous about to take home a child.
Question two, Scott, how did you feel about your first kid? What? Second question comes from me. How do you feel about the next child on the way?
Are you talking to me? Are you asking me?
Who else would I be asking? It's just the two of us. So that wasn't a real Q&A. But as I mentioned, I think Friday I'd like to do a Q&A. So if you have questions, if it's about like family, life, work, business, video, anything, ask it. Do it through Twitter if you can. It'd be even easier for me to keep track of. But if you also just do it in the comments in the video, this video, that's fine too. I'll do my best to answer them on Friday and hopefully give you something different to look at. It'll still be a vlog, but there'll be a Q&A section on it, which I really would like to do on Fridays, because Fridays typically are family days where there's not as much going on, so Q&A would be outstanding. It is really, really warm. It's like 90 degrees and insanely humid, but we're done. See, it's not actually that I mind mowing the lawn. It's just, there's like so much stuff going on right now. It's just the last thing I have time for. Halfway done. Let's do the front.